It's Championship Sunday in the Northeast Conference. Today, women's lacrosse action as top-seeded Quinnipiac looks to get into the NCAA tournament with a win over number 3, Mount St. Mary's. Mount now setting up a new offensive play. Here's a shot and a goal by Larimore.
Up is Mount St. Mary's with great patience. They took off almost 2 minutes of the clock, and Larimore. Here's another one. Catch and shoot. This time it's Caraleo, and she will get the goal, her 51st of the year.
And again, curling around.
Caraleo spinning back to her left, gets off the shot and the goal. What a pretty move for the player of the year of the conference, her second today.
Sinigan had the find. There's the cut, and Caraleo sells it right there. And it's a great defensive player that she's able to shake in Megan Conley.
Cooper will come in, get the shot off, and the goal. 5 goals in the semifinals, gets her first one here.
Allen back behind the net. This is Quinnipiac's maybe longest possession.
On the flip, the shot by Toomey, it's in.
Shading back behind the cage for 5 to 10 seconds. Saw the cutting Toomey, what a catch. And then just swipe it down.
Back 30 minutes away from winning their first ever Northeast Conference championship.
Early on, Mount St. Mary's really tried to slow it down. Did it fluster your team a bit?
No, I don't think so. I think we expect them to. We knew in the regular season that one of the things they did was they take a lot of shots from far out and from bad angles, and it didn't work against us the first time we played. So I expected them to try and change it up and look to be a little more disciplined. I think after our performance on Friday where we were able to push the tempo, if I was the Mount St. Mary's coach, I would have said slow these guys down. So we were sort of prepared for that. I think our team was a little jittery and nervous the first few minutes. You know, big game, they really want to win, they want to come out strong. But once they settled down, they were fine and happy with how they played towards the end.
How about the NEC Player of the Year showing up in a big way in the first half, Marissa Caraleo?
You know, Marissa always shows up for us. Sometimes it's in the big stats that everybody gets noticed with goals and assists, but she's always there, little ground balls, defensive plays, settling our attack down, and, you know, there's a reason why she's the NEC Player of the Year, and I'm sure glad she's on my team.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Danny, first half, you tried to slow it down early. Was that the philosophy here against a team like Quinnipiac that likes to run?
A little bit. I just think we needed to really value our possessions. I think we did that in a good job and got some good shots off. We just weren't able to score on those, and then Quinnipiac really came out and did exactly what we thought they would do and take it to us.
So what are the keys for you in the second half?
We need to be able to clear the ball better. We need to make sure that we just take care of the ball. Okay, that hasn't been a problem for us really. Just being a little nervous, maybe a little tight. So we need to make sure we take time with the ball, get the ball up the field, and make better and smarter decisions.
Coach, good luck in the final 30 minutes.
Thank you.
Toomey will rip in, get a shot off, go low, and beat McTavish. A lot of movement up front. It's Gibney with the shot and the goal. We saw that combination work so well on Friday, and they hook up again today. Matuzak to Gibney as a shot and a goal by Gibney. Another one for her. Make it 4 for number 4. Here's an opportunity for Gibney and another one. 5 for her. Behind the net for Toomey. Here's a shot and a goal for Caraleo. That'll be her third. With 26 seconds to go. 3, with 2, with 1. And Quinnipiac, your winner of the Northeast Conference in women's lacrosse.
Here with NEC champion head coach Danny Caro, Quinnipiac. How does that sound?
Sounds great. I'll tell you what, it's been a long time coming. I give a lot of credit to not only this year's team and the seniors who have been here 3 times and now won it on their 4th try, but all the classes that came before them that really laid the foundation for what we've achieved here with the program. So I couldn't be happier for all our alums, all our support staff, and all our players.
I think you knew coming into today you had a special team, a team that could run up and down the field, that could score a lot of goals. Did you anticipate this defensive performance?
Well, I knew we were capable of it. We had a good plan coming in, and you know, we have this ability, and I'm just glad that they pulled it out on the biggest game of the year.
You know goalkeeping. How about Martello today? She was
awesome.
Great.
She was absolutely awesome. I couldn't be happier for her. She did a great job for us.
Now play-in game opportunity here with Navy, the Patriot League champ. What will it feel like to finally represent the Northeast Conference?
I just hope we can do the Northeast Conference proud. We're just going to go out there and do our best, and hopefully we can keep the season going a little bit longer.
Coach Caro, thanks a lot.
I appreciate it.
We'll also be joined now by Devon Gibney, who had a sensational game for Quinnipiac. The junior midfielder, 6 goals today, double hat trick status. What were you able to do to get your offense going?
We came out really strong from the beginning. We knew what we had to do, and we wanted it so much more than them. We've been wanting it for the past 4 years, and we made it happen. So It was really exciting.
Coming over the hump, obviously you beat Sacred Heart on Friday, and you got that out of the way. But the chance now to put it away. What did Coach Caro tell you guys about not getting complacent, not forgetting you still had to win one more?
She tells us that every game, and today we really took it to heart, and we did what she said, and look at the scoreboard.
Your offensive efficiency was scary. I mean, off the cuts, both you, Matuzak, Caraleo really had it all going. Was that the offensive plan to go attack the middle of Mount St. Mary's defense?
Yeah, we do that every game. You know, we've got solid offensive players, and they called us the trio the other day, and I think we came out again today.
Devin, congratulations. Go celebrate with your teammates.
With 8 goals and 4 assists, the 2011 Northeast Conference Women's Lacrosse Tournament Most Valuable Player is Devon Gibney of Quinnipiac. Now, the 2011 Northeast Conference Women's Lacrosse Tournament Champions, your Quinnipiac University Bobcats. Well, Coach Caro and her team captains, please come forward and accept their award.